Welcome back. The spokesperson of the Supreme Court, Attorney Midas Marquez, calls on members of the judiciary to stand together amid what he calls a dastardly assault. Here are the highlights of his statement before the RTC Judges Association of the Philippines.
As you all know by now, our Chief Justice Renato C. Corona has been impeached in blitzkrieg fashion in an unprecedented, lightning-like coming together of 188 members of the House of Representatives. This astonishing, astounding feat has never been seen in response to urgent legislation long pending and gathering dust in the halls of our revered Congress. Make no mistake, this is an insult not only on the person of Chief Justice Corona, not only on his office, not only on the Supreme Court. This is an assault on all the rights, power, and privileges of the entire judiciary. If you have read the complaint, and I urge all of you to do so, any lawyer worth his salt will have difficulty finding sustainable charges worthy of a conviction in an impeachment proceeding. No doubt, we are staring a constitutional crisis right in its face.
Still with us, House Justice Committee Chair Congressman Niel Tupas Jr. We also have House Minority Leader Edcel Lagman, and joining us for this segment, Integrated Bar of the Philippines President Attorney Roan Libarios. Good evening, Attorney Libarios, and
Good evening,
gentlemen. Well, I will let Congressman Lagman answer the point you raised about the wife of Chief Justice Corona accepting a government position during the time when he was already a Supreme Court Justice.
Well, I understand that the original appointment of Mrs. Corona was made even before he became an Associate Justice of the Supreme Court. But putting that aside, I think the complainants were extrapolating inordinately the canons of judicial ethics. The conflict should not be speculative. It should be actual. And in the case of Mrs. Corona, there was no case which was brought before the Supreme Court, involving John Hay management. So there was no actual conflict of interest there. And moreover, it is the Chief Justice who is the respondent and not the wife.
Let me ask Attorney Libarios, should, when you're saying, as with Congressman Lagman, that the original appointment came when Chief Justice Corona was not yet an Associate Justice of the Supreme Court. But when he was appointed Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, should Mrs. Corona have resigned?
I think so.
She resigned when?
I don't know. I don't know when.
But it doesn't also show that because she failed to resign, the Chief Justice is now guilty of culpable violation of the Constitution. It's a different story. Delicadeza does not necessarily mean that because the wife did not resign, then the Chief Justice can now be sued for culpable violation of the Constitution.
It's betrayal of public trust, not culpable.
Because para magkaiba yata ito eh.
Or even betrayal of public trust, you know.
Because unless if there is a showing, for example, that there was a case involving Camp Jan Hay, which was resolved by the Supreme Court, and probably the Chief Justice did not inhibit or allow the wife to stay in Camp Jan Hay, then that would be a direct issue on conflict of interest.
Let me ask, before you answer, Congressman Tupas, let me ask Attorney Libarios, where does the IBP, Integrated Bar of the Philippines, stand in all this?
No, we had a series of discussions. In fact, kaninang umaga, at saka we had 2 hours and 3 hours of deliberations. We deliberated on the articles of impeachment and with the national officers, and we also had consultations with the regional governors. And we almost had a consensus. It's a consensus, ang feeling pakiramdam namin dito, with all due respect to Congress, to our good chairman of the Justice Committee, we feel that yung nangyaring impeachment actually is an assault on the constitutional status and prerogatives of the Supreme Court as the final arbiter or interpreter on what the law is. We reviewed the articles and we found out that karamihan sa mga charges involve decisions issued by the Supreme Court as a collegial body on matters presented to the court for interpretation of the law, interpretation of the rules. Mm-hmm. Now, katulad, for example, issues about the TRO, issues about the
flip-flopping decision,
the three major laws passed by Congress, Dinagat Island, the redistricting, for example, the 16 municipalities turned into cities. These were laws passed by the House and passed by the Senate. Mm-hmm. And the Chief Justice and the majority merely affirmed these laws as valid. Now, can they now be impeached for saying that? Mm-hmm. Let's go to the TRO, for example, involving, ang sinasabi ng Korte Suprema, that the right to travel cannot be restricted with there is still no pending case before the court. Mm-hmm. So there was a balancing of interest here. Mm-hmm. Now, pwede nagkamali ang Korte Suprema, pwede rin tama ang Korte Suprema. But do you now punish the Supreme Court for saying that it appears that there is basis for the issues of the TRO considering wala pa namang case in court? Mm-hmm. Are we not politicizing the entire issue?
Are you politicizing the entire issue knowing that the president does not like the Chief Justice to be the Chief Justice?
The impeachment proceeding is a political process.
Uh-huh.
So this is the matter will not be decided by the judge, but it will be decided by the representatives of the people, Congress, and the Senate. Mm-hmm. Let me assure the President of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines, Lynda, that we're not attacking the institution. It's not the institution. Mm-hmm. We impeach the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court as a person, and we respect the Supreme Court. Mm-hmm. We impeach the Chief Justice because we want to bring back the faith and confidence of the people in the Supreme Court. It's the only branch in government where it has no power to enforce its own decision, except it relies on credibility and moral suasion. Mm-hmm. And it has lost that. Mm-hmm. That's why I assure the Integrated Bar of the Philippines and the public that we impeach the Chief Justice, and the Chief Justice is not the Supreme Court. Second is with respect to Mrs. Corona.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just the appointment, but the acts of the former president after the appointment, or the promotion in 2006 or 2007.
Seven.
Wherein after that appointment or promotion, the board complained. In fact, the board withdrew the resolution electing Mrs. Corona as president. And what did Ms. Arroyo do? Instead of conducting some investigation, the former president asked all the members of the board, the complainants, to tender their irrevocable resignation. Mm-hmm. How can you explain that?
Mm-hmm. That's very you're saying that the former president sided with Mrs. Corona in that internal...
Sided with Mrs. Corona because to appease the justice of the Supreme Court. Oh.
Those are really blatant conclusions of facts and law. But let me say, Lynda, that... the impeachment is not only against the Chief Justice, because the basis of the impeachment are collegial decisions of the court, majority decisions, and some unanimous decisions. Mm-hmm. And we think that what is being questioned now is not only the integrity of the Chief Justice, but the integrity of the entire Supreme Court. That would be assailing the independence of the Supreme Court, because these are final and executory judgment. And the complainants raised the point that there should be immutable decisions, but they are the ones debasing and destroying this principle, because these are final executory decisions which they are challenging and which they use as basis for the impeachment complaint.
Mm-mm. Let me ask Congressman Tupas, why did you not confine the articles of impeachment to acts allegedly committed by Chief Justice Corona alone? Because somebody pointed out, one of the lawyers said that only three of the eight articles of impeachment directly assail the Chief Justice. The rest involved collegial decisions of the Supreme Court.
Let's go through the articles.
Mm-hmm.
Article 1 is we're questioning the partiality and subservience of Respondent Corona, and it assails him directly.
Okay.
Number 2, we're questioning the non-disclosure
failure to disclose
of the SALN or statement of assets and liabilities and net worth of the respondent, and it assails him directly. Number three is that we are questioning the integrity, and we cited a lot of cases there, questioning to support that to support our stand, and that assails him directly. Article 4 is the status quo ante issued. And I felt
in
that
the case of Ombudsman Mercedes,
I felt that they should all be impeached. But it was a decision taken by the majority that we start from the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, the highest. But it's a, to me, it's a clear culpable violation of the Constitution. Five, it's the flip-flapping. To me, it's a clear violation again of it's a betrayal of public trust. Betrayal, that because the ground there is betrayal of public
trust. Hindi lang siya ang nag-flip-flop.
Hindi lang siya, no? Hindi lang siya. But who? But sino ba ang Supreme? Kasi if you are the Chief Justice, you have also administrative control of the Supreme Court. And diba, in that in that article, we allege mere letter acted by him. Just a mere letter, not a pleading, by a certain
attorney, but unknown lawyer. In the case of FASAP versus Philippine Airlines,
and
right.
as well as League of Cities. Article number six is the creation of the Ethics Committee
to investigate
Del Castillo. He was the one. He was the one as Chief Justice. That's directly
investigated one of the Associate Justices for alleged plagiarism.
Seven, TRO. Well, I will not disclose it now, but we will present some pieces of documentary evidence and testimonial to support our stand, directly attacking also the respondent in Article 7 on TRO. Article 8, it is the GDF, Judiciary Development Fund, and the SAGS special allowances for judges. It was allocated for a specific purpose, and it was used for a different purpose.
Something else, yeah.
Foreign travel and personal expenses. It directly, it's a direct attack against the respondent here in this case.
Okay, Attorney Libarios was shaking his head in one of the articles.
Actually, we also reviewed the same articles and we come out with different findings here. Article 1, for example, sinasabi natin direct attack, but these are subservience in cases where the Chief Justice voted as a group. Either with the minority or the majority. So these are acts in the performance of his duties as part of the Supreme Court. Second, the SALN. The SALN is actually invoking only a ruling of the Supreme Court in 1992 that the SAL shall only be filed before the clerk of court of the Supreme Court.
Saka lahat ng justices, di ba?
Yeah.
They do not disclose.
Correct.
That is for the longest time.
That's correct. Number three, for example.
Number three.
Wrong
practice. The problem is he did that file. But he did file.
He did file in the clerk of court of the Supreme Court.
The allegation is this failure to disclose to the public.
Because the Supreme Court is invoking its fiscal autonomy, its institutional autonomy.
Since 1992, that's the practice. Okay.
That's a resolution covered by the Supreme Court. We go through the other allegations, for example, flip-flopping. The Chief Justice never flip-flopped. The other justices flip-flopped.
So and meaning consistent yung vote
consistent
ni,
voting
ni
niya. He never
Justice
changed
Corona.
His
and,
decision.
And remember, in the case of the League of Cities, the alleged flip-flopping happened when the Chief Justice was not the incumbent Chief Justice. It was a former Chief Justice that tenure that this happened, you know. So the subsequent changes in the decision did happen, but the initial alleged flip-flopping was not during the term of the Chief Justice.
Number four, as to the status quo ante order, true, the Supreme Court issued initially a TRO, but subsequently yielded and allowed the Ombudsman to be tried by Congress. And in many other decisions, for example, doon sa VAT at 12%, nag-issue ang TRO ang Supreme Court sa toll. Eventually, it yielded to the government. ERMM, for example, extension of the elections, postponement. Initially, nag-issue ang Supreme Court ng TRO, but eventually yielded also to the government.
But not with finality, because we have a pending motion for reconsideration because of that very close vote.
So mahirap natin sabihin na these are... Now, the Supreme Court has been very subservient to the previous administration.
Mm-hmm. But Lynda, let me just underscore that in the cases of the alleged gerrymandering in the creation of LGUs, three departments of the government acted favorably on these issues. One, Congress enacted the statute.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Two, the president approved the statute representing the executive. And next, the Supreme Court resolved the issue with finality.
Mm-hmm.
So three departments, the grand departments of the government, participated in the process.
Mm-mm, mm-mm. Okay, you know, earlier today I was listening to Father Bernas, Father Joaquin Bernas, one of course the framers of the Constitution, and he spoke about chilling effect on the judiciary, because in most of the articles it is the decisions of the Supreme Court as an institution that's been assailed. Do you share the same?
We fully share the IBP. We fully share the observations of Dean Bernas that this is actually an anomalous situation. Because the Congress, with all due respect, is asking now to be the final interpreter of what the law is.
Mm-hmm.
They are now subjecting to another review the decisions of the Supreme Court and telling the court that you committed a mistake, that you committed a culpable violation for deciding in this manner.
Mm-hmm. Chilling effect.
Okay. With respect to the chilling effect, probably it's chilling if you have betrayed the public trust, if you culpably violated the Constitution. Congress here is not the final arbiter of the Constitution. By exercising its power of impeachment.
Mm-hmm.
It is reserved to Congress by the Constitution because it is a popular, it's a popular mandate. It's, it's a power by the people. Let's go back to the SALEN. The Statement of Assets and Liabilities under Article 11, Section 17, all of us.
Mm-hmm.
All public officers have to file, but only high-ranking officers, President, Vice President, members of the Supreme Court, and the Officers of the Armed Forces of the Philippines are required to disclose it to the public.
Mm-hmm.
The president disclosed that to the public every year. Tito Edcel Lagman.
Mm-hmm.
We publish it every year for congressmen.
Mm-hmm.
The Supreme Court, they're not above the Constitution.
Mm-hmm. Well,
they're not above the Constitution.
Bakit hindi kayo magpasa ng batas na defining the procedure?
No, we cannot, because it's already very clear in the Constitution. Constitutional construction is clear, nothing to interpret. I can just be allowed. Here, the Supreme Court cannot just issue a mere circular or resolution
saying that
we're always exempted because we are Supreme Court. It's not.
Mm.
Who will be the arbiter? Who will now check the Supreme Court? It's the House of Representatives initially, and we did that.
Mm.
We did that last night.
But why is that CJ Corona's fault alone?
Okay, here. As I said before the president of the IBP arrived, as I said, for me, with respect to the status quo ante order, they should all be impeached. Mm-hmm. It's a culpable violation.
Mm-hmm.
For me, with respect to flip-flopping, there's nothing more clear than that.
Mm-hmm.
They should be impeached.
Nako.
But we have to start somewhere and somehow.
Mm-hmm.
It's not an argument that, Chief Justice lang pala nagkasalanan, baka sila. No.
So,
Congress has to start, and it has never happened in the history, only now. We have to start somewhere, and we did that last night.
So may kasunod pa, some of the Supreme Court justices
must be breaking in their shoes right now.
That is the more cheating effect. And that is what we call the blackmail.
Mm.
Because you are now telling the justices, you better behave and decide in favor of the Aquino administration in cases pending before you, because otherwise you will be next in the impeachment process.
Mm.
You know, that is completely unacceptable.
Mm-hmm.
It is really assailing the independence of the judiciary.
Mm-hmm.
And we could not possibly condone that.
Well, I disagree with my mentor. Congressman Tito Edsel Lagman, what we're saying here is, masyadong garapal na pag Supreme Court ka, you feel that you're supreme and you're God. Because under the Constitution, there's a process. So, we're not saying that you vote in favor of the Aquino. We're saying that you vote naman ng tama naman. Huwag naman garapal na nakita mo naman na maling-mali na yan, itutuloy like yung status quo ante, yung flip-flopping.
No.
And that's what we're saying, because there's a legal, there's a remedy here. The remedy here is Congress can discipline erring members of the Supreme Court.
The problem is, pag decision against the Aquino administration, garapal.
Mm.
You know, What standard are we using?
And you were saying, Attorney Libarios, the problem is?
The problem is that these are decisions made by the Supreme Court based on facts and issues submitted to it for decision, for resolution. For example, let us take the case of yung sinasabi nating flip-flopping of the decisions. The Chief Justice did not flip-flop. Mm-mm. The other justices flip-flop. Mm-hmm. I think one or two committed flip-flopping.
Well, they will impeach all of them. They
Second issue. Remember that the Dinagat Island, remember that the redistricting issue, and remember that the 16 municipalities were laws passed by Congress and passed by the Senate. Mm-hmm. And the Supreme Court merely affirmed these laws. Mm-hmm. Now, can they now be impeached for culpable violation of the Supreme Court for passing those laws?
Okay, well, just this is already a preview of what's going for to be the argument.
Just one quick point here. It was mentioned by Congressman Lagman and the president of the IBP that with respect to the gerrymandering of the two districts in Camarines Sur, it was the three branches of government
passed the law, enacted the law.
Affirm everything. From the legislative to the executive, and I don't know, judiciary. Yeah, and the judiciary. But it doesn't mean that it's the correct thing. Mm-hmm. It doesn't mean it's the correct thing.
In other words,
and it doesn't mean that they cannot be impeached for doing something that is wrong, but was affirmed by them.
Incidentally, you're talking of the redefining of the districts
of Camarines. Because to me,
the chairman of the local government committee in the Senate was Senator Aquino, right?
And only two voted against.
And Senator Aquino.
Only two voted against, huh? Mm. No, Senator Aquino and Pimentel. It was passed in the Senate.
But you know, when we read, like
it
us
was passed
lawyers
in the Senate, so therefore the senators should also be impeached for culpable violation of the Constitution.
No, under the Constitution. Under the Constitution, how can you impeach the senator?
Anyway,
that's the problem.
What Roan was saying is this. If you are impeaching the Chief Justice, for affirming the statutes,
Act of Congress,
then you might as well suspend or discipline the members of Congress who voted in favor of that statute. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we really have to take a short break. Next, when we come back, we will look at the options for the Chief Justice. ANC presents Chief Justice on Trial. We'll be back. Stay with us.